Hey, welcome to Mercy Hill Kids Online. My name's Austin, and I'm so glad that you're here today. We've got some awesome stuff in store for you today. Are you ready? Sweet. Well, stand up. Go ahead. Get up. We're going to jump into some worship. So on the count of three, we're going to say hit it. All right? One, two, three, hit it.
Set us free. Your mighty name will ever be the soundtrack of our victory. We're lifting up your praise like a battle cry. The thunder of your name breaks apart the night. Your matchless grace will ever be the soundtrack of our victory. I know you will tear down the walls. I know you are invincible. The strongholds crumble like castles of sand as we shout loud our Jericho song. Yes, all around the world we're the church alive. We're fighting on our knees with revival fire. Our King shall reign. Soundtrack of our victory. From darkness to light, anytime temptation comes and someone stands to fight, anytime somebody lives to serve and not be served, I know.
God is on the move, hallelujah. God is on the move in many mighty ways. God is on the move, hallelujah. God is on the move,
falls upon their knees or dares to speak the truth that sets men free. Anytime the choice is made to stand upon the word, I know.
God is on the move, hallelujah.
a searching soul, and someone says, send me, here I go.
Months after the Israelites left Egypt, they came to Mount Sinai. God had chosen the Israelites as his special people, and he wanted them to understand what the relationship should look like. He planned to make a covenant or an agreement with them. Moses went up to the mountain. God told him, "This is what you should tell the Israelites. If you listen carefully to me and you keep my covenant, you will be my people." Moses went back to the people and told them what God had said. All the people responded, "We will do all that the Lord has spoken." So Moses went back up to the mountain. The Lord spoke to Moses, "I am going to come in a thick cloud. I want the people to hear me speak to you so that they will believe you." Moses went back down the mountain and got the people ready to meet God. He brought them out of the camp, and they stood at the foot of the mountain. God came down on Mount Sinai in a fire. Smoke covered the mountain. God said, "I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt." Then God gave Moses the Ten Commandments. The first four commandments told the Israelites what it looks like to have a relationship with God. Do not have other gods besides me. Do not make an idol for yourself. Do not misuse the name of the Lord your God. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. The last six commandments told the Israelites what it looks like to have a relationship with one another. Honor your father and your mother. Do not murder. Keep your marriage promises. Do not steal. Do not lie. Do not want what belongs to someone else. When the people heard God talking to Moses, they were afraid. "Do not be afraid," Moses said. "God wants you to fear him, so that you will not sin." Moses went further up the mountain, and for 40 days, God gave Moses many more laws. When God was finished speaking to Moses on Mount Sinai, he gave Moses two stone tablets that he had written on with his own finger. God's law shows us what he requires. Our sin separates us from a holy God, but Jesus came to bring us back to God. When we trust in Jesus, he takes away our sin and gives us his perfect righteousness.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for questions from kids. Hadley from Omaha, Nebraska asked,
"Do we have to follow the Ten Commandments today?"
Oh, Hadley, that's an interesting question. Yes, the Ten Commandments are a part of God's law, and we're required as believers to follow God's law in the Old Testament as well as in the New Testament. You see, in the New Testament, Christ points to an even higher standard, and we see some of this in Matthew chapter 5, verse 21, where Jesus Christ himself is talking to a group of hearers, and he's asking them to think about the things they heard in the Old Testament. Think about what God required in the Old Testament, and then he's pointing them to an even higher standard to follow, because Christ is concerned about us. and the beauty of God's requirements and commandments and laws is that they're in place to protect us. You see, oftentimes the human heart says, I don't like requirements, I don't like laws, I don't want any of those things because I want to do what I want to do, but they are to protect us. You see, even adults are required to follow rules. For example, when your parents or any other adult is driving, they're required to follow the speed limit. And if parents or other adults that are driving, they don't follow the speed limits, there are consequences for not doing what the law requires or what the law commands us to do. And we're told in Scripture that we should love the Lord with our heart. So we want to think about other people. We want to love other people with our affections. We want to love God with our affections. And then the Scripture tells us to love the Lord with your mind. And so we want to think about things that are good and think about things that are right. We want to try to memorize Scripture because we want to love the Lord with our minds. And then the Scripture tells us to love the Lord with our strength. And so with all the energy that you have and all the energy that I have, it should be put towards loving the Lord. The Lord tells us, love the Lord with your heart, soul, mind, and strength. And then he also tells us to love our neighbors as ourselves. And if we do these things, we will show how much we love God and how much we love other people made in his image. Now, there will be some things that will motivate us not to want to love God, like our own evil desires or sin. So I want you to think about what should motivate us to obey God.
Welcome back. Did you have fun? I know, it was awesome. Well, hey, I've got something to tell you. If you thought that was fun, I'd love to invite you to our in-person experiences at all of our campuses for Mercy Hill Kids. There's a link below in the description section that sends you to our website so you can find the nearest location to you. Our staff would love to meet you and even give you a gift. At Mercy Hill Kids, we love to say the most exciting life to live is the one lived for Jesus. So go live a passionate and purpose-filled life for Jesus in your neighborhood today. We'll see you next time.